Principal Lam, President Yik, President Ng, fellow guests, boys of Queen's College, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for having me this morning. Every time when I return to my alma mater, where I was nurtured to be an independent adult, I'm very excited by each of the youthful face shining with energy and in thirst of knowledge about the world. It's lovely. Everything is lovely. The basketball court, even the notice board, the chairs, lovely. And there's no exceptions today. Looking back to my good old days, the open education here taught me to be an active and forever learner to meet the emerging needs of the community. I meet friends here, and the multifarious school life offered me wealth of possibilities to develop my interest, which is so important and crucial to my career. I graduated from university in the years of 1983. It was not a good year. Business was on its downside. Investment was withdrawn. Economy continued to fall, and no one knew how low the lowest points of the trough would be. Hong Kong at that time was moving into a dark tunnels of Sino-British negotiation. The end of it had yet to come. I stayed unemployed for quite a while. My 3 decades of service in Radio Television Hong Kong, however, started with a 1 month part-time job of script writing on classical music. I was so grateful for the knowledge acquired during my QC day. Just said, I play harmonica, flute, Chinese instrument, double bass, cello. I conducted the QC harmonica band, orchestra, and choir, and arranged music for them. I even attained grade A in theory of music by self-learning. Music at that time is just some kind of hobby. However, allowed me to step into the door of public service broadcasting. How miraculous. Later, I was assigned to work and stay at the core service of news and current affairs for over 20 years for my keen interest and sensitivities on social issues, which was also developed from the news discussion groups in QC and accumulated in university where I served as student union president and council chairman. As a lifelong public servant, I wish to extend the definitions of public service today, not only to the 11 young men behind me, but also to everyone of you serving QCs as captains, prefects, chairmen, and all others. My experience conveys 2 lessons. Be prepared and be open. First, be keen on anything you are crazy for, your studies, activities, and friends to prepare yourself. And second, be open, especially in choosing your career. You never know what will call upon you. Boys, today is the open days and the word open is ringing so loud and awakening to me as it is also the core values of key to success of QC, RTHK, and indeed Hong Kong for so many years. In the charter of RTHK, our public purpose is to provide an open platform for the free exchange of views without fear or favor. I repeat, provide an open platform for the free exchange of views without fear or favor. RTHK is also charged to deliver programming which contributes to the openness and cultural diversity of Hong Kong. That reminds us of free speech and social inclusion. How very true. As the British philosopher John Stuart Mill skillfully argued in his famous classic on liberty, that any opinion can be classified into free state, either totally true or entirely false, or partly true and partly false, but no matter how, never silences from open discussion to lose a chance of distilling the truth. This is the fundamental principle of an open society. But that's not enough. Open up your minds to views no matter how unreasonable to you. This is tolerance. You tolerate others, others tolerate you, and that constitutes an open society. Open up to all argument, embrace them, give them all the benefit of doubt and look into it. Truth, as John Stuart Mill explained, is always the product of reconciling and combining of opposites. I repeat, reconciling and combining of opposites. Always appreciate your opponents and learn their lessons. Boys, QCs always prepares us to serve and to lead. Our open minds and liberal thinkings can heal emotions, controversies, and contributes to the open society which houses your views and those opposing yours, houses difference and contradictions, houses sense and nonsense. You hardly agree with them all, but always defend them to death, their right of open discussion. If I may add on, the elements of success of generations of QC servants and leaders, my attempt would be stay open. So this is my anthology, and I'm looking forward to your exciting chapter. Open days is the days to open our door to visitors, to share with them our open schooling that we have established in the last century and a half. This is also a precious opportunity to put your hard work under public inspection, from a design to a display board, from a presentation to a game. Let's listen and learn with an open mind. Further to the anniversary gala dinner, Wonders Asunder, I hosted 2 years ago, our ethos has become Honors Asunder this year. With the kindly instructor, I wish you all every success in joining all Thai collegians to honor our alma mater. Boys, the society is growing in sophistication and expecting high on us. The open days will bring us excitement and vigilance, testing our determination to tackle challenge ahead. We always stand by you. Boys, stay strong for health. Stay thirsty for knowledge. Stay humble for success. Stay hungry for excellence. Stay loyal to your responsibility and stay open to your mind. This is the time to live up to the underlying lyrics of our school song. Molding our manhood, our mind, and our bodies, QC's and old QC's joy in the song. May I call upon 3 cheers from you all, thundering and in unison, to roll out our glorious songs for the commencements of the open day. Boys of Queen's College, 3 cheers to our alma mater. Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Hip hip.
Hooray!
Thank you.